Ladies and gentlemen, from Ontario, California, Premier Boxing Champions now features 8 rounds in the light heavyweight division. Your referee in charge when the bell sounds is Lou Moret. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner. He comes in wearing the black trunks. He is a 10-fight veteran fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Jerhed Fenderson. And across the ring, his opponent fighting out of the blue corner. He comes in wearing the gray, white, and the green. His professional record, a perfect one, 6 wins. 2 of those coming by way of knockout. Fighting out of Pontefract, Wales. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the undefeated Kody Davies.
All right, gentlemen. Okay, gentlemen, I'm getting you a certain dressing room to obey my command, okay? Shake hands and wait the bell. Good luck.
So it is a matchup in the light heavyweight division, making his United States debut, Kody Davies out of Wales. As he goes and tries to make a statement here stateside for the very first time, as he's opposed by Jerhed Fenderson. He's a southpaw, is one Jerhed Fenderson, or Kody Davies. Here in 2018, he has gotten 5 victories, including his first 6-round win, taking on Jerhed Fenderson. As you see, they came in wearing a shirt in tribute to Enzo Calzaghe. And incidentally, Enzo Calzaghe, the father of Joe Calzaghe, former trainer, and Joe Calzaghe, the best Welsh fighter of all time. So certainly know their roots, and big shot by Kody Davies. He's a very big, strong young man, is Kody Davies. That's one thing that stands out, Dominic.
Yeah, Kody looks strong. He definitely is. He's got the stature of one of the bigger light heavyweights. It's also one of those things you're looking at. You're seeing a southpaw against an orthodox again. I have noticed they've stepped on each other's toes a couple times now, but Kody looks to be in demand of things.
He's also part of the group with Joe Joyce. He has similar members of his camp. But making a United States debut, you want to make a statement. 24 years of age, coming here for a reason. Now getting this huge opportunity to be fighting on PBC on FS1.
Yeah, I think these fighters that come here from Europe are definitely understanding that America is definitely where the boxing game is going to stay. And Kody's done a great job of coming here to make his U.S. pro debut. He's come here to win support and fans.
Big straight left by Kody Davies. Davies bouncing around, using his jab well. But Davies has got to get more active. I know it's still the first round, but you would like to see him use his jab a little bit more frequently and pester Jerhed Fenderson.
Yes, I'd like to see a little bit more action out of Davies. He should be in the demand structure here. He is popping the jab. That kind of goes away when you find an orthodox fighter as a southpaw. At the same hand, I have yet to see Fenderson come out putting activity together.
10 seconds.
It is your typical opening round for somebody.
And that's the end of the first.
If you go down, if you go more than one, you can't get on the
Welcome back to PBC on FS1, Kody Davies and Jerhed Fenderson. What did you see out of the first round from Kody Davies?
You know, we did get a lot of action there. Although Kody Davies did a good job of establishing his jab, establishing the ring rotation, he's keeping his foot on the outside. I'd like to see Davies come out here in the second round and put a little bit more activity together.
Kody Davies, 24 years of age, straight left down the center to the midsection of Jerhed Fenderson. Ray Flores, Dominic Brazil here in Ontario, California, the prelims of PBC on FS1. Still have five bouts on our main card. Fenderson is smiling at Davies, but I don't know if that's a ploy to try to get him to be a little more erratic or more aggressive, Dominic.
No, I think at this point, Fenderson's just trying things. He doesn't look very normal or natural in the southpaw position. Davies should definitely capitalize on this and push forward and just test him, see what he's got. As you can see, Fenderson just went back to his orthodox position. I guarantee if Fenderson goes back to southpaw, Davies is going to press the issue and get some shots and combinations off.
What Davies is, I don't know if he's, now he's getting on the inside. When he throws, he does throw some combinations when he gets comfortable on the inside. But Fenderson's been doing a lot of talking and a lot of motion with his face, things along those lines, and not much fighting.
Yeah, I think Fenderson's playing more the mental game. He's trying to rattle Davies a little bit here. He's smiling at him. He's talking to him. Davies needs to stay on his P's and Q's and continue to fire the jab and put the big left hand behind it.
Nice right hook followed by a left upstairs. Now Davies is pressing the issue. Coming inside, looking to back up Fenderson.
Fenderson doesn't have much to say anymore now that he's backed up into the corner.
Nice left uppercut. Jab by Kody Davies.
Davies has got an orthodox type of a southpaw style, both hands down. He's got a lot of shoulder and hand movement, but it's working for him. He's putting combinations together, and he's getting off.
Now he's getting more active. I mean, the athleticism is there for Kody Davies. You're seeing he's able to do things. He's able to turn it up. He's strong. He's muscular. I don't think his muscle impedes him whatsoever when it comes to speed-wise.
Yeah, usually when you have a big statured guy with the muscular structure, usually they're a little bit more stiff, but he's very fluent in his movements. He's flowing real well. He's carrying himself around the ring as if he might have been a welterweight or even middleweight. Just to see light heavyweights moving like this is always good.
Final moments of round two. This one's scheduled for 8. Welcome back to PBC on FS1. Jerhed Fenderson in action against Kody Davies, making his United States debut as Davies out of Wales.
Punch low while you're down there. Don't come up.
If you're in the corner of Fenderson, what are you telling him?
I'm telling him that he's got to have a lot more activity. Fenderson hasn't thrown nearly enough punches. He hasn't tried to establish his jab, nor is he trying to establish his defense. He's doing a lot more talking than he is doing action.
He's got to look. He has a 4-6 record. He started off strong there. Another right hand.
Fenderson looks like he's got a look in his eye that he's wanted to try some things this round, and I'm hoping he does.
Kody Davies. So I know you're faster than that. Well, his corner is trying to implore him. They're telling Fenderson, we know you're faster than that, but Fenderson didn't do much in the first two rounds.
Yeah, he he's definitely waiting for maybe the next bell to ring, the fourth round to show up. I think Davies needs to take advantage of Fenderson's layoff or his
lack
delay.
Of activity.
Yeah, lack of activity.
I mean, just start to really pump that jab and go to work. Yeah.
I think here in the third round is when Davies needs to show that he can both go backwards and forwards. He can pop the jab, stick it, and maybe set
when up, start paying.
Throw some feints, set something up.
Well, Fenderson is more concerned with talking to the crowd than what is the actual fight.
Yeah, I think somebody should have told Fenderson in the locker room, this is a boxing match, not a talking match.
100 seconds left here in round three. Davies steps inside with that jab right to the abdominal region of Fenderson. Davies with a straight left, another one. 65 seconds left here in round three.
No, sir.
Kody Davies looking to take his record to 7-0, and I don't think right now through the first three rounds he's in any danger whatsoever, Dominic.
Yeah, I don't believe so either. Davies is controlling the fight here. Although we haven't seen a ton of activity, Fenderson has not shown me anything that is dangerous at all. I would like to see Davies get a lot more active, even considering that his opponent is inactive. And there's the switch we see again, and that's where Davies should be taking advantage of his opponent.
Now Davies is using some theatrics as well. Man, oh man, both of these guys are alternating when it comes to everything but what they're trying to do inside the ring.
Yeah, they're at this point, both fighters are searching for something. Fenderson is talking and smiling. He's trying to get into Davies' head mentally, but Davies got to stick with what he's doing.
That's the end of round three. We'll come back with round number four. Kody Davies and Jerhed Fenderson. See Jesse Rodriguez, the 18-year-old out of Los Angeles. He puts his undefeated record on the line against Edwin Reyes. It's PBC on FS1, the prelims, as we continue embarking on round number four between Kody Davies and Jerhed Fenderson. Dominic, through three, how do you have it?
Through three, I've got Davies ahead on the card for sure. He's been more active. He's landed more shots. I'd like to see Davies to just turn it up just a little bit more, get a little bit more confidence in it, and put some work in.
Well, when he throws combinations, he's effective. I mean, Fenderson is crafty enough to get out of danger sometimes, but Davies, if he pushes the issue, could very well, I mean, it's possible he could get him out of there, right? At least really start to have more separation in terms of this fight.
Yes, Ray, I believe so. I think if Davey turns it up just slightly a bit more, puts combinations together between threes and fours, maybe five combination punches, backs his opponent up against the ropes, he might get the victory a little earlier than he'd like this evening. But as of right now, he's taking a step in the wrong direction by going backwards. Not that it's a bad thing. I'd just like to see Davies push the issue, be more of an aggressor.
Yeah, Davies certainly should be the one that is starting the contact. And now Fenderson comes forward. Right hook. Also, as we Right hook to the body by Davies, and he gets out of the way. Smart move. Now he's starting to be more active, Dominic.
Yeah, he's being more active. Fenderson walking right towards him, giving him pretty much a heavy back on the legs. I like to see at this point Fenderson block a shot, throw a shot, counter well.
Fenderson coming forward. Now Fenderson, okay, now they're starting to throw some leather.
Come on.
Also want to send a special get well to our great friend, one of my dearest friends, Brittany Goosen Brown. She had some health issues a couple of weeks ago, and I know that she's at home watching in her lovely state in Sherman Oaks. So Brittany, get better. Can't wait for you to be back.
Definitely, Brittany, we'd like to see you get better, get well soon.
Under a minute left here in the fourth.
You know, with Fenderson stepping forward and kind of pressing the issue, it brings Davies' activity level a lot higher. He's throwing combinations now, he's sticking the jab, moving. This is the fight that I was actually looking to see.
Well, now this is kind of what people want to see out of both. Davies is starting to have a guy, a lively body in front of him, and Fenderson, I don't know what happened in between that second and, or the third and the fourth round, Dominic, but Fenderson is pushing the issue more.
Yeah, definitely. I think the Fenderson's corner by maybe told him he was behind on the cards and he needed to press the issue. He's got his gloves up high and he's stepping right to him.
10 seconds. And a right hook to the body is Davies. We're halfway home of this 8-round matchup. There we see Edwin Reyes, the 31-year-old out of Las Vegas. He gets set for his main event affair on the prelim portion of PBC on FS1. He will battle Jesse Rodriguez coming up in only moments. Right now, round number five. This one scheduled for 8 between Kody Davies and Jerhed Fenderson. Dominic, through four, how do you see the fight?
I still have Fenderson up ahead. I have Davies up ahead on the cards. He's got all four rounds. Fenderson is doing something that I like, where he's got his hands up high and he's walking to Davies. Although Fenderson needs to straighten out his shots, and that's a good right hand there, but if he continues to throw looping shots, he's never going to touch Davies.
Right hook to the body by Davies. Fenderson is coming forward, trying to at least engage Davies, which he wasn't doing in the first three rounds.
Yes, he's definitely stepping forward, guards up high. I don't know if Fenders realizes it, but every time he touches Davies, he kind of rattles him a little bit. Davies is doing a great job adjusting, keeping his space, and his reach at par.
Slides in a right hand, does Fenderson.
Fenderson's going to walk in. He's going to have to continue to keep those hands up, that guard up high.
Yeah, he just got popped by a straight left. Compliments of Kody Davies. Again, Davies throws a right hook to the body of Fenderson.
You've got to appreciate what Davies is doing. He has a southpaw. You're used to seeing a counterpuncher. He didn't come out that way, but he's working some great angles. I like his bounce in his legs. I like how he gets off. He's always finishing with that right hook as a southpaw. That's one thing that gets you out of danger.
That's a lot of energy that he's expending too, Dominic, when it comes to moving around the ring and now he's being pressured. In the first couple rounds he was not, but he's expending some energy here in round four and five.
He definitely is using some energy. He's dipping down into the fuel tank a little bit to move and get out of danger and dip and dodge, but it's the fight style that he's doing right now with Fenderson walking him down.
Fenderson Fenderson coming forward. Hey, don't forget to engage with us on social media. Use the hashtag PBC on FS1. Follow us at Premier Boxing. Use the hashtag PBC on FS1 and follow us at Premier Boxing. And don't forget, a new season of PBC on FS on Fox, it starts in December. So talk about an early holiday gift. Fury Wilder on Showtime pay-per-view and the new season of PBC on Fox.
You know, the new season of PBC on Fox, as a fighter, as a fan, as a supporter, family, you've got to be excited when you hear the news of something like that. I can't wait. It's, you know, Christmas came early.
Oh, no question about it. As we near the end of round number five between Kody Davies and Jerhed Fenderson. Don't forget Saturday, December 1st, the WBC Heavyweight Championship of the World is on the line on Showtime pay-per-view. It is Deontay Wilder, the Bronze Bomber, putting his world title on the line against Tyson Fury. That'll be at Staples Center in Los Angeles, Saturday, December 1st on Showtime pay-per-view. That's a fight, Dominic, you are going to have your eyes glued to.
Oh, that's a fight I'm definitely going to be there in person for. I've got to be ringside for that one. You know, being the WBC mandatory, I'm excited. I can't wait to see who comes as the victor in that one. Because, you know, I'm next in line, and I've got to start studying now.
Okay, so I know you said you picked Tyson Fury, but if you had your choice, who would you want to fight?
If I had
since you're the mandatory.
Yeah, if I had my choice, Deontay Wilder is the guy I want to face. We've got a little bit of bad blood going on outside the ring, and we got some things we need to square off inside the ring. And, you know, what better fight would you like to see the last two U.S. heavyweight Olympians square off in the ring? And if it was up to me, it would definitely be on the West Coast, something like the Staples Center, T-Mobile Arena. I think the fight fans would appreciate two U.S. big statured heavyweight Olympians.
Love to see it, but right now we are watching Kody Davies and Jerhed Fenderson. Davies has done well, but he could be doing very well.
Yeah,
Davies
has done some things well, but if he put his punches together, like I was saying earlier in his fours and fives, here in the sixth round is when you need to try some things. You're in an eight-round bout. You've done a great job thus far, but it's time to try some things. It's time to put combinations together. It's get away from the counter and the checks and start taking a little bit of demand in the ring.
Midway point around six. Using that jab is Kody Davies. Here, Jerhed Fenderson, do you almost think, Dominic, by his body language, that he's just thinking, all right, I'm going to take the loss, but I'm going to make this guy work a little bit?
You know, I don't think Fenderson's got that in his mind. Never as a fighter, you ever thinking you're down on the cards or you're under. But Fenderson has some body language that leads to believe that his confidence is breaking. You know, when he was walking Davies down the last round, his hands were high. He wasn't getting hit with as many shots. This round, his hands are lower. He's taking some deep breaths. It leads me to believe that he doesn't want to see the eighth card come up or the eighth round show up.
Ray Flores, Dominic Brazil. Still one more bout on a preliminary portion. Then we have five-bout main card. Right hook by Kody Davies as we approach 30 seconds. But again, let's look at things in context. This guy is his seventh pro fight, making his U.S. debut, so the goal is just to come out and get a victory.
That's always the goal when you step foot in the ring, is to get a victory. But with being a European fighter and your seven fights being over, you know, overseas, you step into the U.S. TV primetime type of situation, and you want to make a statement. You want to let everybody know in your division, and this being the light heavyweight division, that I'm here to stay, and I'm a force to be reckoned with.
As we near the end of the sixth. Welcome back to PBC on FS1 as we look at Kody Davies being attended to by his trainers. And there you see the corner of Kody Davies. They have to be pleased with him, but I know that they could probably be thinking, okay, he could be doing better.
Yeah, yes, Cody's is definitely pleased with him. I'm sure they're asking him to do a couple more things that they've had done in training camp, and hopefully we see him here in the seventh round.
I think that, look, Davies looks fundamentally sound. He has quick feet. He's athletic. The punching power is something that is lacking. And maybe it is because his opponent is not coming forward as much, but as we look at his resume, 6-0 with two knockouts, so sometimes punching power comes on when someone is in their mid-20s from a guy's standpoint, Dominic.
Yeah, as a fighter, we always mature. As we get older, as we get more experience, we understand shifting the shoulders and the hips, and rotating it just back and forth from right hand to left hand, our power is generated. Tonight, Cody's done a phenomenal job of showing some great boxing skills. I like the jab, I like the combinations he's putting together, but at the same time, I'd like to see him sit down a little bit more and throw the leather.
I love the jab when Davies throws it a lot. It's it sort of stabs you upwards.
Yes. His jab, he's firing a straight one. He's using an up jab. One thing I've noticed in the last couple of rounds here, he's put a feint before his jab, and it's putting Fenderson almost had to look like he's a deer in the headlights. He doesn't know what to do with the feint. He doesn't know what to do when the jab, hits him upside the head. It's Davies' job to capitalize on that feint jab and follow up with a big left hand.
Fenderson looks bewildered at times.
Yes, I think the fuel tank is running a little low on Fenderson now. He was pressing the issue the last couple of rounds. Now he's kind of just sitting back and waiting for an opportunity, but that's not his fight style. That's not what he should be looking for.
Coming forward is Fenderson. But Davies throws a couple of right hooks that were blocked. Now Fenderson, he clipped Davies. Now Fenderson, see if he decides to chase and try to get some offense going. More sustained offense. He just hit a couple of jabs in the right hook. Right hook to the body. As quickly as he started his offense, Kody Davies pulled the halt to the
Kody Davies is nice. He's doing a good job of rotating on the shots now. As the rounds go on, he's sitting down a little bit more, whereas his opponent, Fenderson, is throwing more or less arm punches. Those big looping shots, when you get close to your opponent, is not likely to land. I know he did land there in the last 20 seconds or so, but right now, he looks like he's just swinging for the fence.
Well, he's technically superior to Kody Davies without question.
Yes, Kody Davies has done a great job.
Last round, touch gloves.
We gotta knock them out, Jerhed. We need a street fight.
Okay, you wanna continue?
Yes, sir.
We are back here, PBC on FS1. There you see the corner of Jerhed Fenderson, and now at this point, Dominic, I have him trailing by a large amount. He's gotta really push the issue.
Yeah, Fenderson's gotta come out here and give the judges something to look at. It's been the same thing round after round. I know he has pushed the issue a little bit and put his guard up and stepped right to him, but Fenderson needs to show the judges that he was here from the opening round.
It's the eighth and final round. Kody Davies out of Wales. He's trying to take his record to 7-0. They're fighting in the memory of that of Enzo Calzaghe, who passed away. Enzo Calzaghe, the former trainer of his son, the best Welsh fighter of all time, Jill Calzaghe. It has been a one-sided clinic for Kody Davies on Jerhed Fenderson.
It has. And well said, Ray. It has been a one-sided clinic here. Davies has done some boxing things and has had some great movements, some great feints. I like how he's using the up jab and the straight jab. He's got Fenderson fishing for things. Fenderson doesn't quite know what he wants to do.
And Davies still going ahead and using his distance well, jabbing. Big right hand by Fenderson. Fenderson's not, he has to go now. He really has to go. He's got to start things. Because he has 100 seconds and he's starting to really throw caution to the wind now. Jerhed Fenderson, his corner's imploring him, like, come on, you got to go.
Yeah, you know this is your last round. You know you're down in the cards. You got to put this, you know, pedal to the metal and keep it going. You can't let up at this point. You got to make Davies uncomfortable. You got to throw everything. I mean, empty the tank out. Throw stuff you're not used to throwing. Go impress the judges.
You're at the Citizens Business Bank Arena. Thank you very much for joining us. It's PBC on FS1. The prelim portion, still one more bout in the prelim portion, and then we get going with our main card. Five bouts on the main card, including two heavyweight matchups you do not want to miss. And stick with us here throughout the entire evening for PBC on FS1. As Kody Davies hammers on Fenderson with the right hook.
Davies looks good. He looks like he definitely had a good camp. His legs still have bounce in them. He's still firing combinations. It's always good to see out of a fighter.
Still to come, the light flyweights, Jesse Rodriguez, Edwin Reyes, and then we will move on to the featherweights. Nice jab by Kody Davies. And that's been pretty much his calling card. The jab followed by the straight left. And the ring generalship of Davies has, without question, been far greater than that of Jerhed Fenderson. Now he's backing up Fenderson. Look at this to end the fight for Kody Davies, the 24-year-old out of Wales, making his United States debut. And we will come back and get the decision. You are watching PBC on FS1. Thank you. Welcome back to PBC on FS1. Kody Davies, Jerhed Fenderson, they fight and they go the distance. Here's some of the action from the fight, Dominic.
Yeah, Davies had the control of this fight from the opening round. He did some great things there. He established the jab. He looked good as a boxer and moved around the ring real well. Here in the third, Fenderson had some things to say, and he switched up to an unorthodox position, and Davies showboated on him a little bit. He told him that I'm in control of this fight, and you got to come get me.
And Davies, again, it was just masterful with his jab and that straight left.
I like what Davies did here at the end of the round. He told the judges, Fenderson did come to fight, but I also came to fight, and he showed off there in those last seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen, having gone the distance, we go to the scorecards. All three judges, Fernando Villarreal, Max DeLuca, and Alejandro Lochin, see the bout identical, 80-72 for your winner by unanimous decision. And still undefeated, Kody Davies. So Kody Davies is now 7-0 with two knockouts. His U.S. debut, he didn't lose a single round, and it was a clinical performance out of Kody Davies.
You know, Davies was great there in that fight. It's as your U.S. debut, that's what you want to get. You came here to make a statement, and he did well doing so. To get a win and a victory like tonight in an arena like this, on a show like this, it's going to step you up in your game.